GamesMaster was a TV series in the early 90s featuring video game competitions. But was it any good? Let's have a little look. In 1992, a new series would come to Channel 4 for all teenagers who love video games. And if you remember watching this back then you'll remember the excitement of watching it. Viewers got to see other people competing with each other on various games on different platforms to become the winner of the GamesMaster Golden Joystick.
Thank you very much and welcome to GamesMaster.
The show was presented by Dominic Diamond and featured regular commentators such as Jazz Rignall, Neil West and the legendary Dave Perry, and of course the GamesMaster himself, who was Sir Patrick Moore. And it's all set in a church, which was odd but certainly different. As we didn't have the internet at the time, sources like magazines and TV shows were the only way we could find out about upcoming releases and if they're any good. The beauty of TV shows is you could see the game playing rather than a crappy screenshot in a magazine. And speaking of magazines, there was also a run of them to read for when the show wasn't on. For viewers who already owned the game, there may be some relief you needed when you got stuck. There would be the consultation cheats and tips section, where the Games Master would be asked a question regarding a game, whether it be how to do something in a game or simply entering a code to cheat through the game.
Some of these, now you look back on it, they were pretty helpful. But the odd time you just get one that's fucking ridiculous. I mean, take a look at this.
Hello, Games Master. I always get killed by the blue lobster whenever I play at Revenge of Shinobi. How can I kill him?
Well, you need to show a little initiative, young man. When you enter the chamber, jump onto the left-hand wall. Then, as he attacks and lowers his sword, you need to jump, somersault, and shoot. If you repeat this procedure a number of times, you will overcome this villainous shellfish.
Thank you very much.
That's the first boss. It's not hard to work out. When the Revenge of Shinobi came out, I was 11 and still managed to work out how to beat him without any problem. Even if these were set up just for the show, just to help people out in the obvious hard parts of the game, this wasn't a tough part of the game. Just show us the infinite shurikens cheat and fuck off.
You're right there, Games Master.
Welcome to my fortress, young man. How can I be of assistance?
Can you tell me how to get past the fucking title screen on Sonic the Hedgehog?
Ah yes, quite an easy one, this one. At the title screen, simply press start. From there, you can play the rest of the game.
Oh, fucking hell, that's fucking great.
You're welcome. Goodbye.
There would also be short reviews on a few games normally done by magazine editors, and they look 90s as fuck with their floppy hair. A little kid who knew fuck all about games, or maybe someone's dad. And look, it's Radeon Automatic, nicknamed after the washing powder that died in the 90s, just like his fucking haircut. And unless my memory for all those years has been erased, I don't remember half the games they talk about on here. Some of the challenges were tough, like this one here where he has to get a certain amount of coins and finish the level before the time runs out. And it was always pretty close. And look at the lad playing it. Look at his hair! Everyone had a friend with that dude that didn't move. And the involuntary hair flick is there too. Remember your mate with that twitch?
A bit tense and nervous.
There were some great challenges with the sports games. The tension was real and it could swing either way. And it wasn't just random people from home, there were celebrities involved too. Like Take That, Jimmy White, Vinnie Jones, and WWF legend Hacksaw Jim Duggan. Even two old dears go head to head on King of the Monsters.
Yeah. What's up,
There will be news on new peripherals which were due to be released, and upcoming consoles like the Neo Geo.
The scene, console buyers face greater choice than ever before, the Neo Geo.
Most consoles claim to have arcade style, arcade quality graphics and sound. With the Neo Geo, you've actually got an arcade machine. If you're feeling rich, and you're feeling like the most powerful machine available, then the Neo Geo is the one to have, but it is a lot of money.
Yes, it really was that expensive back then. You'd have to be born with a silver spoon up your ass to own one of them. A regular challenge would be played now and then, which would be Heimdall, where the player had to throw axes by a drunken Viking at some damsel strapped to a board with ropes all around. The challenge would be to cut all ropes in a certain amount of time. Also, there was my favourite, Sonic Blastman arcade machine, where the player must hit the pad as hard as he can to take a chunk out of a meteor. The power of each punch would show up as megatons and show how much matter has been smashed off it with each hit. All this was great until Series 3 came along. Dominic was replaced by Dexter Fletcher and wasn't well received. He was better known for his role in the TV series The Press Gang, and he should have stayed there. He was over the top and in your face, but the series was still appealing with great challenges and some great guests. They got Johnny Cage and Sonya Blade on the show to play as themselves on Mortal Kombat. Now that was pretty exciting at the time, as the game was a massive hit. Dexter was soon dropped from the show, and Dominic returned from Series 4 until the very end in Series 7. Not much else changed really, but we did get to see the Master of Games, Dave Perry, fail at his challenge on Mario 64 and sulked big time and claimed he'd been set up.
Some might say cowardly, some might say clever. He is literally staying on his bottom and trying to last long as he can, but I don't think it's one. He tries to play conservative, a good tandem, but he lasts for 13.35 seconds. That means Kirk Ewing is the winner! Okay, guys, let's start with you, Kirk. Congratulations, first of all. Interesting way you handled this quiz, Kirk. Abysmal at the start, from zero to hero at the end. I didn't even think that time was a very good time.
No, it was a rotten time, let's be honest.
Now, on to you, Dave. Now, you have, as you said on the show, you are the greatest games player in Britain. What happened? What went wrong?
Well, I think I've been set up fairly badly here today.
Right. And particular what reason?
I think having a final game where one player owns the game and the machine and one player doesn't isn't in the interests of fair play.
Uh-huh. OK, then, so what you're saying, Dave, is the biggest game of this year. You haven't played much.
It's not released till next year. I'll play it next year when it's released in this country.
OK, you are a journalist. We can get it on import.
Not a journalist. I'm a marketing manager.
Right, OK, then. And you don't have a book coming out about, you know, games or anything like that, no?
About beat-em-up.
About beat-em-up games. So we're not seeing Sir Grips at all here, Dave, is what you're trying to say.
No, we're not. We're seeing somebody just saying he's been set up.
By who, Dave? If you shit at a game, just accept it, smile politely, and fuck off.
Okay then, and on that bombshell, let's award the Gory Games Master Joystick to the new Games Animal, Mr. Kirk Ewing!
Bless him. To me, it looked like he was trying to take a shortcut to make his opponent look stupid, but he misjudged and plummeted to his death. He went from trying to look smug to looking like a complete mug. His opponent had already failed at 20 seconds, so he could have just stayed on course for 1 second longer. By Series 7 they'd moved well into the 32-bit era, and the series after so many years was wearing thin, just like Dominic's hair. It was set on a desert island and lacked the atmosphere previous shows had. This would be the last series, and the last episode was basically the best of GamesMaster, which was nice to look back on some classic clips. Dominic's sarcasm and wit would surely be missed.
I'd go rollerblading.
What do you like about rollerblading?
I know, it's fast.
Well, you've certainly convinced me that I think I'm going to go out and get one right away. So finally arrived
after all the hype. There was a bit of competition at the same time with Bad Influence on ITV, but this was more of a tech show-off with news and upcoming consoles and games, and not forgetting the mental Namrud for all your cheats and tips.
Zombies ate my neighbours on the SNES. It's a password that lets you jump straight to level 48. Just enter WWJ.
And some may remember Total Reality, which was a total pile of shit with its computer-generated presenter that looked like a character from the series Reboot. It wasn't until now, in 2021, that we saw a reboot of the show. Now obviously Sir Patrick Moore couldn't return as the Games Master, but is that Dominic?
Only the brave stand before him, the fearless and the bold.
Is it fuck? It's Robert Florence. No, I've no fucking clue either. With the Scottish accent, you may have briefly been fooled into believing it was Dominic returning, but no. He is accompanied by Frankie Ward and Ty Logan. But that's not to say he won't be any good. Sir Trevor McDonald takes the role of the Games Master, which oddly works quite well. The platform remains the same with the challenges, and I must say the first one seemed near impossible. But fair play to him, he smashed it, which I really didn't think would happen. The series sadly doesn't have a consultation zone, probably because modern games don't have the insane challenge like retro games had, where you only had a limited number of lives, and the fear of failing in a game doesn't really exist anymore. With modern consoles not requiring gimmicky peripherals, there isn't much need for a section on the show of the latest add-ons. The show has more competitive challenges in it, which kind of makes up for these missing sections. It's early days, but so far it doesn't seem like a bad reboot. And there's lots of reboots that try to impress and fail miserably. This is more common in movies though. This was a great run of series and very nostalgic for me. And maybe in another 30 years, the new one will be nostalgic to all the younger viewers. So I say good luck to them. It seems pretty good so far, and hopefully it won't fail to impress.
Now I'm joined here with Dave Perry. Dave, do you think that Games Master is the greatest show on telly?
No, I don't think it is. I think I've been set up really badly here today.
So it's not the greatest game show?
No, I think bad influences.
But there's a new series.
That doesn't come out till next year.
Well, surely you can review it before anyone else, as you're a journalist.
I'm not a journalist, I'm a massive wanker.
Well, even wankers can see things firsthand. So we're not seeing sour grapes here?
No, you're seeing someone who likes bad influence.
And on that bombshell, thanks very much for watching and good night.